Hi, this is Recycler, and today we're going to be recreating this song. Using just this tiny device. This is the PO33KO. I already talked about it in this video. Also, this video is part of my Recreating Classics series, so make sure you check the entire playlist. Alright, so to recreate this song, we need to start with the main sample, Prison Song by Carlton Williams. The original BPM of Mask Off is 152. However, unfortunately, the PO33 doesn't have time stretch features, so I had to play around with the pitch to find a good compromise between the sample's original tempo and pitch and the final song's tempo and pitch, if that makes sense. I ended up with my beat being one semitone up and 5 BPMs down compared to the original Mask Off by Future. This beat was made by Metro Boomin, who's an absolutely genius producer. And quite a few years ago, he also made some of his drum samples freely available. I don't remember which site, but he did. And so that's what we're using here. Let's get to the bass. So here's a bit of advice for recording bass in the PO33. This device doesn't really process loud, low end very well. So it's always better to find sounds that are also rich in mids and highs. But also, check your input levels and try to record at low volumes. Otherwise you end up with what I can only describe as digital lo-fi farts. So I found this sound that seemed to do the job, although I still had to cut some high end. Also, the tail end kind of glides down in pitch, giving me a detuned feeling that I don't particularly like. Oh well, I'm tired of digging for 808 sounds, so this will do fine. So we have the main loop here. Let's work on the variation, which is basically the same, but with some faster hi-hats here and there. Here is a useful tip. On the PO33, you can actually use parameter lock. Using this button combination, you press on the step that you want to alter, and then you press on BPM will allow you to re-trigger a double or quadruple the speed, which is great for trap beats. Now, I'm also moving the knob, which is completely stupid. I shouldn't have done that. I changed the BPM and now I have to do it again. All right. Okay, time for the intro now. In the original song, the main sample is pitched down an octave and it's time stretched and other things happening. I don't know exactly what, but again, the PO33 doesn't have time stretch, so I had to slice the sample up and rearrange it in such a way that kind of mimics the original song. Also, the PO33 doesn't go more than an octave down or up, and my sample needed to go exactly 13 semitones down. So I had to kind of cheat and load the sample in Koala Sampler to go, minus one semitone first and then load it onto the PO33 and have it an octave down. Now, the next part of the song is the one containing the sample of the woman singing. Also, in this case, the length of the sample doesn't really match up with the tempo of the beat, so it kind of creates some blank space at the end that could have been filled with time stretch, but, you know, again, we don't have it, so... Right. So, for the final performance, all I have to do is punch in all the patterns in a cohesive sequence. I have the intro loop here, the main loop there, the second loop there, and the sung part there. So, let's do this. There you have it. We've recreated Mask Off by Future entirely on the PO33KO. I know it doesn't sound exactly like the one on the record, but, you know, it's pretty damn close. If you like this video, please hit the like and subscribe buttons, and let me know in the comments what recreation you want to see next. See ya!